App Builder makes it really easy to work with dialogs. In this video, you're going to see the built-in dialog functionality, as well as how to create a custom dialog. Here I am inside of App Builder in an empty view. So I just created an empty project. The first thing I'm going to do is go to the toolbox and find a button. I want to add a button to the form, and this button's actually going to trigger our dialog. Now for this button, I want to set a margin so it looks a little bit better on the screen. So when I preview this app, you can see the button is a little off of the upper left. Let's go back to edit. The other thing I want to do is change the theme here. Why don't we do a fluent dark theme so we have a nice dark background with the green button. And I also want to change the content of this button to add new item. Next, we'll add a dialog. Instead of going to the toolbox, you'll learn a new trick here by hitting Control E and typing in dialog. So Control E means control everything, and this helper pops up, and then you can just type in what you want once you start getting used to the components and just select what should go on the form. So the way that dialogs work is they're actually overlays on top of an existing form. So you can see in the upper left here, I've got my master view, and then I've got my overlay. And then the overlay would have multiple things here if you had multiple dialogues or snacks or toasts or whatever happened to be on your screen. I'll click dialog window. Now I'm in edit mode for dialog window. You could also go to the left-hand DOM outline and select the area that you wanted to edit as well. So the dialog has several flavors. If we go to the right-hand pane where the properties are, you'll see we've got a confirmation, which is the default, an alert, and a custom dialog. If I go back to confirmation, you can see some of the properties that you can set. Like this is the header here, which will allow you to customize the text. You can customize whatever message. So that will update as well as what the buttons say. So here we'll just say yes, no. And so I'm basically customizing this dialog to how I want it to work. You can also check or uncheck options here for click outside to close or press escape to close. I'll leave those just the way they are. And then the other area that you can customize is what happens on the click of these buttons. So by default, they're going to do the open close event and they're targeting themselves. But if you want to show or hide something or navigate somewhere else and you had other screens or components on the form, you can easily customize this in the interactions pane. So now if I click the preview button, you'll see that when I click add new item, nothing happens. The reason for that is we didn't wire up the button to trigger the dialog. So I'm going to select my button. I'm going to scroll down, go to interactions. I am going to open close, and I'm gonna pick the dialog window component. So now what that's gonna do is exactly what it says. When I click this button, it'll open and close the dialog. So let's go ahead and click the button, and you can see I've got my dialog that I created and customized some of the properties on. Let's go back to edit, and let's go back to our dialog. And what we wanna do now is change this to a custom content dialog. And I wanna get you familiar with what you can do here. So the body one, basically a label, it's a text input, is a placeholder for whatever you want to put here. You can put text or you can delete it like I'm going to do, and you can see that there is a default area for a placeholder here. What I want to do is I want to add a column layout to this dialog, and then I'm going to add components into the column layout. To set the size of the dialog, you would go up here to the width and height property. So I'm going to set this to 300 pixels wide. And I want the height to be 400 pixels tall. What this does is it changes the size of the dialog. So the dialog is going to be controlled by the child container. Since this is an add new item dialog, let's go ahead and add an input. So we'll do an input group. Now the input group has some properties of its own. So what type of input group, text, numeric, email, password, content, the label placeholder. So I'm going to change the label placeholder to say name of new item. And next I want to set the padding on this. So when I add components underneath it, they all are spaced nicely. So I'm going to go to the spacing option and I'm going to say, give me a 20 pixel spacing around this component. And I'm going to select this item and I'm going to say the width should be 100%. But when I do 100%, you'll notice that it kind of goes outside the bounds of the form. What you can do is click the icon next to the spacing margin options and then specify which margins you may want to change. So in this case, I want to change the leftmost margin to 0. So now everything is aligned perfectly. The next component I want to add is a text area. And this is something that'll allow me to add additional text besides one line. So a multi-line text box, essentially. We'll call this description. And I'll do the same thing. Instead of 20 pixel border. And let's change this guy to 0. And we'll change his width to 100%. Like so. And next, let's do another cool control. We'll do a combo box, and we'll do some data binding here. So I got my combo, and you guessed it, we're gonna change this to 20 pixels. We're gonna go here, change this to 0, change the width to 100%. And you'll see we've got a default data binding here because we have a data source here for Northwind, and I have a few other data sources as well. But in this demo, what we're gonna do is use the category name display property. So let's go to name, and you can see here I've got my combo box. And then finally, let's add one more control. Let's add a date picker. And I'm gonna do the same thing. Let's do our 20 pixel border. Let's make it 0 on the left. And let's make this 100%. Now this component is interesting because it does not have a placeholder. So what I'm gonna do is go to Control E again. I'm gonna find this text label input and I want to add that above my calendar. And I'm gonna modify the spacing, the border of this guy. So let's change the top spacing, which I think is this one here. So we'll change this to maybe 5 pixels. And I think that looks good. Yeah, and it looks like my column layout needs to be extended a little bit. So how about 425 pixels high? So that tweaks it a little bit. And instead of body one here, let's change this to expiration date, like so. And for my combo box, let's take the placeholder here for select category. There we go. Okay, so it looks like we got everything we need. I've created a custom dialog with components, added some spacing to make it look good, added a data bound field, added a date picker. Let's see how this looks. We'll click preview. We'll click our add new item. Our dialog pops up. Say test item. And description, just so you can see how this works with the text area. I have some multi-line text there. I can resize this and you can see there's a bunch of text I pasted. Let's select our category and let's pick our expiration date and then click our button for submit. So let's go ahead and modify that. Click edit again, go back to our dialog, change button here to submit. And let's do an interaction on click, open, close. And we're going to open close our dialog window. And that's it. So now when I run this, new item, click submit, my dialog goes away. So in a couple of minutes, you can add a dialog to a screen, use any of the defaults that are shipped with the app builder, or create your own custom form with actions. To get more great videos like this to learn how to use the app builder and other infragistics tools, click the subscribe button to get a notification when we post new content.